In this video, we are going to see class 9 max, same algebraic identities. Part 2 we are going to cover in this session. So already we have seen the first 4 identities. I hope you all studied that. And in this video, we are going to see the next 4 identities. So the 5th identity is x plus y plus z the whole squared is equal to x squared plus y squared plus z squared plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. And the 6th one is x plus y the whole cube is equal to x cube plus y cube plus 3xy into x plus y. This can be written as x cube plus y cube. This you can multiply with this two terms. So this can be written as 3x square y plus 3x y square. Okay, in this format also we can write. So the next 7th identity is x minus y the whole cube equal to x cube minus y cube minus 3xy into x minus y. The same identity, but the sign has changed. Okay, so this also can be written as x cube minus y cube minus this with this and this. Okay, so this can be written as minus 3x squared y, and here minus into minus it become plus 3xy squared. Okay, so the next one is x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to x plus y plus z into x squared plus y squared plus z squared minus xy minus yz minus zx. Okay, these are the next 4 identities. Now we are going to solve some questions based on this. Some questions using this 4 identities. Okay, so let's move on to the first question. The first question is example 19 in NCERT book. Write 3a plus 4b plus 5c the whole squared in expanded form. By seeing this expression, you can get to know this is fourth identity, that is x plus y plus z the whole squared. So we are going to write that identity. So x plus y plus z the whole squared is equal to x squared plus y squared plus z squared plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. So in your rough column, you have to write which is x, y as well as z. So x is 3a and y is 4b, z is 5c. When you are writing homework also, you have to mention this x, y, z value in your rough work. And now we are going to apply this in this expression. Okay, so instead of x, y, z, we are going to substitute these values. So 3a the whole squared plus 4b the whole squared plus 5c the whole squared plus 2 into 3a into 4b plus 2 into 4b into 5c plus 2 into 5c into 3a. So this can be written as 3a squared will be 9a squared plus 4 square, 4b squared can be written as 16b squared. Then 5c squared can be written as 25c squared. Here 2 into 3 it becomes 2, 3 is 6, 6, 4 is 24. So this can be written as 24ab plus 2, 4 is 8, 8, 5 is 40. So 40bc plus 2, 5 is 10, 10 into 3 it becomes 30. CA. Okay, CA or AC. That's all. This will be the answer. Okay, so in this way you have to solve. Just if you learn the identity, it will become very easy. Okay, without learning identity, it will become so tough. So try to learn all the identities, and you should be you should by head everything. You have that all 8 identities, you have to keep it in your fingertip. Then if you learn this, this will be very, very simple. Within a fraction of seconds, you can able to solve the questions. Okay. So the next question is expand 4a minus 2b minus 3c the whole square. That is example 20 in NCERT book. So now this 4a minus 2b minus 3c, the whole square is, I'm going to write in this format because it is also the same identity, right? X plus y plus z, the whole square. But instead of x, they have given minus. So that I'm going to change 4a minus 2b minus 3c, the whole square can be written as 4a plus minus 2b the whole square. Okay, sorry, not square. The square we are going to make it as a common, no? So plus minus 3c the whole square. Okay, so now this is looking like x plus y plus z the whole square. So in rough work, what you have to write, which is x, which is y, and which is z. So x will be 4a and y will be minus 2b and z become minus 3c. Don't forget to write the minus. Okay, so the formula is x plus y plus z the whole square is equal to x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. So instead of this x, y, z, we are going to substitute these values. Okay, so let's substitute the values. It become 4a the whole square plus minus 2b the whole square plus minus 3c the whole square plus 2 into 4a into minus 2b plus 2 into minus 2b into minus 3c plus 2 into minus 3c into 4a. So it's become 4a square can be written as 16a square, and minus 2b square can be written as plus 4b square, because minus 2, if you squared, it will become plus 4, right? So minus 3c the whole square can be written as 9c square. As I said, minus 3 squared, it will become plus 9. So here 2 4s are 8, 8 2s are 16, and minus sign is there. So it's become minus 16ab, and here a 2 minus is there, so it become plus. So 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, 12bc. Here only 1 minus, so we have to use the minus sign. 2 3s are 6, 6 4s are 24. So 24ac, okay. So this will be the answer. Okay. So in this way, you have to solve this kind of questions. Now let's move on to the next question. Next question is example 21. The question is factorize 4x squared plus y squared plus z squared minus 4xy minus 2yz and plus 4xz. Okay. So now we are going to write this, we are going to simplify this, okay? So remaining things we have expanded. Now we are going to simplify this. So let's take this left hand side, not only for the left hand side, this same thing. I'm not going to write the question again, so I'm just going to start. So this 4x, the 4x squared can be written as 2x the whole squared plus y squared, okay, and plus z squared. Okay, so here minus term is there, so definitely any one of this x, y, z, any one of this is become minus. See, look at here, here x, y terms are there, here y, z terms are there. So these two terms only have minus term, minus sign, right? So which is common, which variable is common? Y is common. So that y is going to become a minus sign. So this I'm going to change into minus sign. Okay, now can you understand why I have changed the sign? Here it is minus. So definitely one of this term is become z minus. That's why this two terms got minus sign. So here y is a common variable, that's why I have changed the sign of the y term. Okay, so now y z term we have written. This minus 4xy can be written as plus 2 into 2x into minus y. Okay. Then plus 2 into minus y into z. Okay. And plus 2 into z into 2x. Okay. Shall we written like this? Both the same? No. So now we are going to use identity by using identity. We know that this is the formula for x plus y plus z the whole square. So this can be written as x is 2x, right? 2x plus minus y plus z the whole square. So this can be written as 2x minus y plus z the whole square. That's all. This will be the answer. Okay. So the next question is example 22. The question is write the following cubes in the expanded form. Two subdivision they have given. So now we are going to solve the first one. The question is 3a plus 4b the whole cube. So we know that x plus y the whole cube, that identity we are going to use here, okay? So x plus y the whole cube is equal to x cube plus y cube plus 3xy into x plus y. So this identity we are going to use. So now we are going to write the question 3a plus 4b the whole cube is equal to, instead of x and y, we are going to substitute this 3a and 4b, okay? So 3a the whole cube plus 4b the whole cube plus 3 into 3a into 4b, then 3a plus 4b, okay? So 3a cube means it will become 27. 3 cube will be 27, a cube plus 4 cube will be 64, b cube plus 3 3s are 9, 9 4s are 36, right? So 36 AB into 3A plus 4B. So this can be written as 27 A cube plus 64 B cube. This I'm going to multiply with this two terms, okay? So 36, if I'm multiply by 3, 3 6 are 18, then 3 3 are 9, 9 plus 1 become 108. So 108 A squared B plus 36 into 4, it will become 4 and 144, okay? So 144 a b squared. Understood? So this will be the answer for the first subdivision, okay? Now second subdivision. Second subdivision, the question is 5p minus 3q the whole cube. 5p minus 3q the whole cube. The same question we are going to write, we are going to use the same identity, but here it is a minus sign, right? So let's use the identity x minus y the whole cube is equal to x cube minus y cube minus 3xy into x minus y, okay? So this identity we are going to use. Here the question is 5p minus 3q the whole cube. So instead of x and y, we are going to substitute 5p and 3q. So 5p the whole cube minus 3q the whole cube, 3 into 5p into 3q into 5p minus 3q. So now 5q will become 125 p cube minus 3 cube will be 27 q cube, then 3 5s are 15, 15 into 3 it will become 45. So 45 p cube into 5 p minus 3 cube. So this can be written as 125 p cube minus 27 q cube minus, so this we are going to multiply with this two terms, okay? So 45 into 5, it will become 225. 225 p square q, then 45 into 3 it will become 45 into 3 it will become 135 p q square. So this will be the answer for second subdivision. That's it, okay? Now we are going to solve the next question, example 23. Evaluate each of the following using suitable identities. 104 the whole cube and 999 the whole cube, okay? So already in the last previous video, we have seen that questions like this. So this 104 can be written as, first subdivision, this 104 can be written as 100 plus 4 the whole cube, okay? So this is in the format of x plus y the whole cube. So what is the formula for this? X cube plus y cube plus 3xy into x plus y. So that identity only we are going to use here. So here 100 plus 4 the whole cube is equal to 100 cube plus 4 cube plus 3 into 4 into 100 into 100 plus 4. So this will become here 6 zeros we have to add, no? So 100 so 6 zeros are here, then 4 cube it will become 64, 3 fours are 12 into 100 it will become 1200 into 104. So 1200 into 104, this should be done in rough work, okay? So 4 2s are 8, 0, 1 2 is 2 and 1 4 is 4, 0, 1. So 8, 4, 2, 1. This become 1, 2, 4, 8. So here it is 64 plus, this has become 1, 2, 4, 8 and 2 more zeros we have to add. So if you add everything, we will get 11,24,864. No commas. This should be written like this. Okay, so this will be the answer. Now we are going to write the second subdivision. So second subdivision is 999 the whole cube, right? So this can be written as 999 whole cube can be written as 1000 minus 1 the whole cube, the same formula. So we are going to use this as x and y. So 1000 cube minus 1 cube minus 3 into 1000 into 1 and into 1000 minus 1, okay? So then 1000 cube we have to write 9 zeros. Okay, so minus 1 and minus 3001, okay, 3000 into 999, okay? So again we have to write the same. Minus 1 minus 3 into 999, it will become 2997. So again 3 more zeros we have to add. So if you minus everything, you will get this answer, okay? This will be the answer for this question. Understood? The next question is example 24. Factorize 8x cube plus 27y cube plus 36x squared y plus 54xy squared. By seeing these two terms, you can get to know this is x plus y the whole cube. So we are going to simplify this. Okay, so let's write 8x cube can be written as 2x the whole cube, and this 27y cube can be written as 3y the whole cube, and this will be 3 into 4x squared into 3y. Okay, because here x squared and y, now 3x squared y will be there, no? So we are going to write like this. Okay, then this will be 3xy squared, am I right? So this will be 3xy squared. So I'm going to write like this, 3 into 9y squared. This will be the squared, this is y term, y squared means it will be 9y squared, right? And then 2x. So this can be written as 2x the whole cube plus 3y the whole cube plus 3 into 2x the whole square. Okay, this can be written as 2x the whole square sorry, into 3y plus 3 into 3y the whole square into 2x. So this whatever square term, that I make it as a whole square. Okay, so this can be written as, this is in the form of x plus y the whole cube, right? So 2x plus 3y the whole cube, that's all. This will be the answer. Okay, now the next question, example 25. Factorize 8x cube plus y cube plus 27z cube minus 18xyz. So this can be written as 8x cube can be written as 2x the whole cube plus y cube, and plus 27z cube can be written as 3z the whole cube minus 3 into 2xy 3z. Okay, so now this is in the form of, so this is in the form of last identity, that is x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to x plus y plus z into x squared plus y squared plus z squared minus xy minus yz and minus zx. So this is in this format. So this can be written as 2x plus y plus 3z into 2x the whole square plus y square plus 3z the whole square minus 2x into y, then minus y into 3z and minus 2x into 3z. Okay, so this can be written as 2x plus y plus 3z and 4x squared plus y squared plus 9z squared minus 2xy minus 3yz and minus 6zx. That's it. Okay, so this will be the answer. So now we are going to see exercise problem, exercise 2.5, 16th question. What are the possible expressions for the dimension of the cuboid whose volumes are given below? They have given the volume of a cuboid like this. We solved a problem in the last video also, but that is a area of a square. Here they have given the volume of a cuboid. So in the same format we are going to solve. What is the formula for volume of a cuboid? Volume of a cuboid is equal to LBH. This is the formula for volume of a cuboid, right? So we are going to change the given expression into this format. Okay, so let's write the first one. The first one is 3x squared minus 12x, am I right? So here, which is common, 3x is common, so I am going to take 3x outside. 3x, if I taken out, here it will be x and here it will be minus 4. So this is in the format of LBH. L is 3, B is x and h is equal to x minus 4. So we got the answer. That's it. Okay, now the second subdivision we are going to take. Here the volume is 12 ky squared plus 8ky minus 20k. So here which is common? 4 is common, right? So 4k I'm going to take. 4k is common. So I'm going to take it out. If I taken 4k outside of this term, the 12ky squared will become 3k already we have taken. So 3y squared plus 2y, not plus, minus 5. Okay, so it will become like this. Now by splitting the middle term, we are going to do this. Okay, so first we have to take a product of this. It will become minus 15, right? This you have to done in your rough column. So it will become minus 15. When you are adding the products, you should get 2y. So minus 15 means 115 will be there, then 2 we will not get, 3 we will not get, 3 we will get 3 5s, right? So this can be written, because when you are adding plus 3 minus 5, we will get plus 2, no, sorry, plus 5 minus 3, you will get 2. So we can write 3 and 5 we can write. So this can be written as 4k into 3y squared minus 5y and plus 3y, not minus, plus 5y and minus 3y, then minus 5. Okay, understood? So what we got in the last step? 4k into 3y squared plus 5y minus 3y and minus 5. So this is step we have got in the last step. So now we are going to compare this 2 and this 2. Okay, this is 5. So 4k into here, which is common, y is common. So y I am going to take it out. So it will become 3y plus 5 and here minus, I am going to take it out. So it will become 3y plus 5. Okay. So 4k into, here 3y plus 5 is common, no, 3y plus 5 is common and then y minus 1. So this will be the second one. Now this is looking like LBH. So here L is 4k and b is 3y plus 5 and h is y minus 1. That's all. This will be the answer. Okay, answer for the second subdivision. So in the next video we are going to cover some problems based on the all 8 identities. Okay, so try to learn all those things and just watch the video again and again, then you will get to know how to proceed using identities, okay? And try to learn all the 8 identities. Thanks for watching.